Oh, wow. Are you trying something new with your hair?
No, what do you mean?
Look at yourself.
What happened to my hair?
Honestly, I think it's kind of cool.
It looks like a bird's nest.
Looks like you have some pink strands of hair now, too.
Apparently. I guess it could have been worse. It could have been country.
I fell in love with an emo girl. All I wanted.
Very funny.
You know, you kind of look like Machine Gun Kelly, too.
Thanks.
Why do you look like Hot Topic threw up on you?
Guys, okay, it wasn't me. It was my soulmate. I don't want to dress like this.
You know, maybe you should. It kind of suits you. Maybe your soulmate just has a crush on Avril Lavigne.
That's fair. Me too.
Or they might be like a super famous rock star.
I really doubt that, but it would be super cool.
Guys, is that who I think it is? Looks like your rock star isn't that far away after all.
She's back, and with more fashion trends from the 2000s that we have to bring back.
Listen, hear me out for 1 second. The denim on denim is kind of hot. I love it. Especially in like this couple's aesthetic and with the necklace, I'm obsessed. I will now be buying a denim corset. Tracksuits, like why did we ever stop wearing these? They're so cute and you don't have to put any effort in because it already matches. I'm gonna buy this, but in hot pink. Just everything about Christina Aguilera, the gloves, the chain, the hats, I love the hat. Obviously, I already did the braids too. I think they're so cute. Also, just everything Avril Lavigne did. Like, are you kidding me? This is the coolest thing I've ever seen. I have these arm cuffs and I bought a tie because of this look. I'm obsessed with cargo pants and I'm very glad that they're coming back into style. Let me know what trends you miss from the 2000s because I have so many more. These are some trends from the 2000s that we need to bring back immediately. First of all, the black and white hair. It's just so good. I wish I could do it, but I'm afraid I'm gonna burn all my hair off. Somebody else needs to eat this up and tag me, please. You might want to argue with me, but low-rise jeans, and hear me out. As someone who is not very tall, this makes my torso look so much longer because I have children-sized legs. The crimped hair, mwah, mwah. Why did we ever stop doing this? I kind of love the texture. It's fun, it's crazy, it's messy, but on purpose. Last but not least, okay, this whole aesthetic. The belt and the cargos and the bracelets, yes. I would literally wear this tomorrow if I had all of this. Comment a trend that you want to see come back.
Please give me invisibility. I look like a rat's ass today.
Persuasion.
Hey, sis.
Don't you dare ask me.
Yeah, can you drive me to school today?
No, I already told you. You embarrass me.
You will.
Okay, yeah, hop in.
Cool.
And that's why you can't get it up.
You two are fighting again?
Oh, when are we not?
You should just be in love again. It was so much better that way.
I love you so much, honey. Fuck the divorce.
I like this.
You need to see me after class. You got a 69%.
No, I didn't. I got 100%.
Wait, what? Did you really?
I did.
I must have read it wrong. It's 100.
Erin!
What's up, slut?
We should go on a date.
Ew, fuck no.
You will take me on a date.
I would rather jump off a cliff.
What? I want you to take me on a date.
And I want to be happy, but we can't all have what we want.
Crap.
Why do penguins have wings but they can't fly?
Hey, Bailey, we have something for you to start on.
You have a job for me to do? I've worked here 5 years and you've never given me anything to do.
No offense, but you have more beauty than you have brains. There's this rich man we believe has been embezzling money and he's looking for a babysitter.
Okay, I'm not a babysitter. I hate kids.
We're gonna temporarily change your job label and you'll be the babysitter.
Is he at least hot?
Are you talking about the kid?
Ew, no, the father.
This is why we don't assign you to anything.
This is the biggest house I've ever seen.
Oh, welcome. You must be the new babysitter.
Yes, I am.
Sorry, what was that?
Nothing. Let's go.
All right, and here he is. Please meet Michael.
Where's the child?
You're babysitting him on the couch.
He's like fully grown.
He's irresponsible. Keep him out of trouble or you're fired.
Hey, is this biology?
Yeah, it is.
Then why is nobody else in here?
Oh, someone stabbed the teacher and nobody really comes to class anyways.
Okay.
Do you want to take a sip of this?
What is it?
It's red wine and a bunch of stuff I found in my dad's closet.
It's 8 a.m. on a Wednesday.
When you guys talk, I see rainbows coming out of your mouth like a unicorn.
I think we need to call the nurse.
We don't have a nurse anymore. She got scared and quit.
What kind of school doesn't have a nurse?
Don't look now, but it's Nate Jacobs. Him and Maddie are fighting again.
That kid's in high school. He looks like he's 27. That girl is not wearing clothes. Do you guys even have like a dress code?
Nah, last time they enforced that, a teacher got bitten.
Mm.
Do you want a hit of this?
Are you smoking inside?
Yeah, do you want some or not?
I'm good, thank you.
You guys have probably figured out by now, I am obsessed with music. It brings me to life, which is why you can join me live on Tidal on April 4th using their new live session feature. You can listen to my top 10 tracks that prove romance is dead. I cannot wait to share these with you all, so make sure you join the live session.
Your total's 20 even.
Babe, I'm so sorry. I don't think I have enough.
Hey, it's okay. I got it.
Sorry if I embarrassed you back there.
No, you're fine. I understand you're going through a tough time with your job.
Tomorrow, when the amount in my bank account appears, it might come as a bit of a shock to you.
Listen, I don't care how low that number is. I'm gonna love you just the same. Poor thing, it's time to see how little he has. What? My boyfriend is a billionaire? No, there has to be some sort of mistake.
I take it you saw my account?
Yeah, and you've got a lot to explain. Whose Ferrari is in our driveway?
That's mine. Well, actually, it's going to be yours now.
What? No, I am still mad at you.
Come with me and I'll explain everything. There was a good reason for me lying.
Oh yeah? Was there a good reason for you having me buy your meals for the past year? Heck, I even paid your rent one time.
I know. And I'll be paying you back for all of it.
Why didn't you just tell me?
Because every girl I've ever dated has used me for my money. I was tired of dating gold diggers, and I wanted to find a girl who liked me for me. I promise, I will make it all up to you, and I'm going to start by showing you where I really live.
Whoa, now hold up. You have a Chick-fil-A in your kitchen?
Yep, and there's a McDonald's upstairs.
Babe, who are you, Richie Rich?
Excuse me for just a moment.
This is crazy.
One of my stocks just went up. A lot.
Yeah, actually, I can see that. Why don't you look happy?
I'm worried about your safety. You can't tell anyone that you're dating a billionaire.
Why can't people know I'm dating a billionaire?
Because I'm now one of the youngest billionaires alive.
And is that a bad thing?
I know a lot of people that would die to get their hands on my money.
And you think they'll come after me?
I know they will. Promise me you won't tell anyone about my money.
Okay, I promise, but you do owe me quite a bit of cash, so what do you say? You take me on a little shopping spree?
Well, I can't be seen buying you a bunch of stuff, but I can give you this.
Babe, this is like 10K. You didn't owe me this much.
I know. Consider it a thank you for being so kind to me. I want you to spoil yourself.
Oh, hey, Lizzie.
Where's your boyfriend? He's at his house. Why?
Oh, nothing. I just think it's kind of sad how he never buys you anything. I mean, look at all the stuff you had to buy yourself. It must be hard to date someone poor.
Actually, he's not poor. He's one of the richest people alive.
What?
Did you enjoy your shopping spree?
Yeah, sure did.
Good. I also bought you this necklace.
Babe, it's beautiful. Thank you.
Delivery for Elizabeth?
Yes, how much do I owe you?
Oh, it's not you who's gonna owe me money. It's your boyfriend.
Lizzie, it's 1 a.m. Why are you up?
This isn't Lizzie, but if you want to see her again, you're gonna do exactly as I say.
You want me to wire you $1 billion?
Yeah, do it now or she's gone.
No, I'll send it. It's done. Now let me speak to her.
Okay, talk.
Liam, I'm so sorry. This is all my fault. I accidentally told someone that you were...
It's okay. I planned for this. Remember that necklace I gave you?
Yeah.
It's a tracker, babe.
No! Please, freeze!
Thank you, Liam. I'm glad you were able to get your money back.
I don't care about the money. I'm just happy you're okay.
Look at this dude I'm talking to. He is so fine. What happened to the dude you were talking to last week? Yeah, I blocked him. I'm like everything. What do you mean you blocked him? I asked him what he was doing and he said he was going to the gym. Like J-I-M. You blocked him because he said a single word that you did not like. Yes, what else was I supposed to do? That was the worst thing I've ever heard. Okay.
Hey, table 5 needs a refill on their wine.
Okay, I'll do it in one sec. Here's another drink for you guys. Is there anything else I can get you?
No, but you seem like a beautiful soul. Have a Merry Christmas.
Thanks.
Someone left a gift for you on the to-go counter.
A gift? Maybe it's from one of my regulars.
You're so lucky. I wish I'd get a gift.
You are the most beautiful girl I've ever seen. Enjoy the makeup, Secret Santa? I don't know anyone who would have given me an anonymous gift.
The mystery is part of the fun. Enjoy it. Hey, Bailey.
I am not taking table 4. They smell like broccoli and BO.
No, there's another gift for you.
Oh. Here's something to remind you of me, Secret Santa. I have to find out who's been leaving me these.
Excuse me, ladies.
Everyone keep taking breaths. Get as much air as you can.
I'm trying. Why are they gonna limit our breaths anyway? This is stupid.
We're running out of oxygen, so this was their solution, I guess. Why aren't you taking any breaths?
I am.
They just sent them out. I got a million.
What?
How many did you get?
I only got 4.
Close your mouth right now. Don't waste any of your air. You need to hold your breath for as long as you physically can today, okay? Do you not have any breaths? You look like a chipmunk. Wait, like none at all? You need to be careful. You're gonna die. Are you okay? You look a little pale. Are you sure? Because you don't look very good. Oh my god, are you okay? Oh no. Can someone give her more breath? She only has 2 left. I can do it. I have a lot of them. Then do it. She needs them now. I just did.
Thank you.
Whoever distributes the breaths must really not like you.
What? Get ready with me as I tell you guys about the time I had a stalker. When I first moved to LA, I lived in an apartment complex that had a gym with it. But then I moved to somewhere that had no amenities at all, so I had to go and get a different gym membership. Since my rent had gone up, I was like, bitch, I'm gonna save some money and go to Planet Fitness. Key piece of information, this was not in the best area at all. Everything had been totally fine, no weird experiences, until this one day I smiled at a dude in the parking lot and then he left a note on my windshield. I was just trying to be friendly because he was getting out of the car right next to me, but the note basically said, "You're cute, call me," and I kind of laughed at it and never did because it's weird. Fast forward 2 months, I had gotten a new car and it was like 9 p.m. I come out of the gym and there is a sticky note pasted right above my door handle.
This is what the note said.
Obviously, someone was butthurt that I didn't text them. This man knew what my old car looked like, now knew what my new car looked like, and knew what time I went to the gym. I went back the next day and canceled it immediately, but they couldn't do anything about it.
I know you guys tell me to stop messing with my hair, but my bangs need a trim. Am I gonna go to a stylist? No. I'm gonna cut them myself with my baby tiny scissors. I just wanna do some baby pieces in the front because I don't trust myself, but I also can't see because of the bangs. Okay, I'm just gonna say fuck it and start cutting. I don't wanna mess them up. That's my biggest worry, that they're just gonna like look really bad.
I don't think that that's even.
I think I need to cut a little bit more on this side. Hopefully I won't regret this. Okay, I'm too scared and I barely took anything off, but I can definitely see now, which is good. I think that they're cute and my hair is always really messy, so you probably won't even tell if they're kind of uneven. Okay guys, I just got back from the festival day 2 and my hair is looking a little crazy, but the makeup has stayed on for the entire duration of the festival because of this NYX Cosmetics mattifying setting spray. It is so impressive and look at these stars.